authorizing reemployment of certificated staff for the 2022-23 school term, plus dismissal notices, resignations, and retirements. Whereas this Board of Education has received recommendations from members of the administration concerning the number of teachers and educational support personnel needed to be employed in the school district for the 2022-23 school term. And whereas the Board of Education has received recommendations from members of the administration concerning the subject area needs and corresponding teaching positions of this district for the 2022-23 school term. Now therefore be it resolved by the Board of Education, Bremen Community High School District Number 228, Cook County, Illinois, as follows. Section 1, that the following staff on contractual continued service shall be reemployed for the 2022-23 school term. From Jamila Abadason Mason through Renee Younger. Section 2, that the following first year probationary teachers shall be reemployed for the 2022-23 school term and placed on second year probationary status. Anthony David through Michael Young. Section 3, that the following second year probationary teachers be reemployed for the 2022-23 school term and placed on the third year probationary status. Kim Bergman through Jennifer Santor. Section 4, that the following third year probationary teachers be reemployed for the 2022-23 school term and placed on fourth year probationary status. Samantha Bio through Roger Young. Section 5, that the following fourth year probationary teachers be reemployed and placed on tenure for the 2022-23 school term. Eric Boyer through Lakeisha Stewart. Section 6, that the tenure teachers as listed be honorably dismissed, effective at the end of the 2021-22 school term for the following reasons: A, declining enrollment; B, teachers returning from leaves; and C, fluctuations in the subject area needs. There are none. Section 7, that the following fourth year probationary teachers hereby be dismissed at the end of the 2021-22 school term due to a decision of this Board of Education to discontinue particular types of teaching services or for reasons included in notices approved by the Board of Education. There are none. Section 8, that the following third year probationary teachers staff hereby be dismissed at the end of the 2021-22 school term. There are none. Section 9, that the following second year probationary teachers hereby be dismissed at the end of the 2021-22 school term. There are none. Section 10, that the following first year probationary teachers are dismissed at the end of the 2021-22 school term: Vincent Lyons, Kyron Weaver. Section 11, that the following part-time and long-term substitute teachers are dismissed at the end of the 2021-22 school term or the effective date as outlined in their individual employment agreements: Christian Allenson through David Zolzinski. Section 12, that the following resignations, retirements, leaves be accepted on the effective date as listed: Michael Brown through Lisa Wunar. Section 13, that the President of the Board of Education is directed to sign all required letters, dismissal notice, and cause the school district administration to send such notices to each person requiring the same by certified mail and personal delivery. Section 14, that this resolution shall be in full force and effect upon its adoption.
All right, can I get a motion to open the floor for a public hearing concerning the staffing recommendations?
I move to open the floor to the public for discussion concerning the staffing recommendations for the 2022-23 school year.
Second.
Moved by Mr. Whitcomb, second by Ms. Gleason. Roll call, please.
Mr. Whitcomb?
Aye.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. Camworth?
Aye.
Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
Is there any discussion? For the public? All right, thank you. Can I get a motion to close the floor to public discussion concerning the staffing recommendations for the 2022-2023 school year?
I move to close the floor to public discussion concerning the staffing recommendations for the 2022-23 school year.
Second. Moved by Mr. Whitcomb, second by Ms. Gleason. Can I get roll call, please?
Mr. Whitcomb?
Aye.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. Camworth?
Aye.
Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
Can I get a motion to approve the resolution and notice of non-renewal?
I move to approve the resolution authorizing the reemployment of teachers and certificated support personnel for the 2022-23 school year and notices of dismissal, resignations, leaves, and retirements.
Second.
Moved by Mr. Wickham, second by Ms. Gleason. Roll call, please.
Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. Camworth, aye. Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
All right, moving on to items three, board minute approval. Can I get a motion to approve the February 15th, 2022 regular and closed meeting minutes?
So moved. Second.
Moved by Ms. Camworth, second by Ms. List. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Mrs. Camworth, aye. Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mrs. Gleason?
Abstain.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
Can I get a motion to approve the March 8th, 2022 committee of the whole and closed meeting minutes?
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Mr. Wickham, second by Ms. Gleason. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. Camworth, aye. Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
All right, moving on to public comments. Do we have any public comments today? All right, we're gonna go on to reports. Our superintendent report, 5.1.
Thank you, Mrs. Russell. During the month of April and into May, our school's drama departments will be hosting their spring plays or musicals. These events are a great opportunity for community members to see our talented drama students in their element. Bremen High School will present Beauty and the Beast on April 29th at 7 p.m., April 30th at 3 p.m., and May 1st at 3 p.m. Hillcrest High School will present The Odd Couple on April 23rd at 4 p.m., April 24th at 6 p.m., and April 25th at 4 p.m. Oak Forest High School will present Mamma Mia on April 22nd and 23rd at 7 p.m., and on April 24th at 2 p.m. Tinley Park High School will present Back to the 80s on April 29th and 30th at 7 p.m. and May 1st at 12 p.m. And then a little reminder plug that this Saturday is the Fine Arts Fest here at Tinley Park. It's a clinic with performances from 9 to 2:30. If you're interested, Tiffany has a more detailed outline of the events, and we're happy to share that with you too if you're planning on stopping by. But otherwise, just some good events to look forward to in the next upcoming months.
Thank you. Item 5.2, our principal reports.
Okay, thank you, good evening. At Oak Forest High School, the winter athletics wrapped up with a successful run. We had three notable accomplishments for our athletes. Bruno Carrillo took sixth in state dive, and we had Robbie Avila and Janae Kent. They were named all-state players for the basketball teams. Our science team took first place in the conference, the SSC conference competition. DECA had 12 students attend state with 9 national qualifiers. And BPA had 5 students that were able to attend state, qualify for state, and they all qualified for nationals. So all of those events are upcoming. Last week we hosted a benefit concert with the Tinley and Oak Forest combined choirs. It was called the Blast from the Past, and there was all kinds of 70s music. There was a special shout out of teachers who went and performed. You can catch that on the Oak Forest channel. They're gonna be posting that, but that was certainly a crowd favorite there. They raised over $2,600 for the National Awareness of Mental Illness Corporation. So one last thing, I wanna just send out an invitation. Anyone who would like to come and attend on April 7th, we are gonna be hosting a wheelchair basketball game. Some of our basketball players, girls and boys basketball, as well as some staff, and then some Oak Forest leadership individuals are going to be playing the Lincoln Way Special Rec Association basketball team, who just had a successful run, and I believe took second in the state competition. So we're gonna be hosting that on April 7th at 6:30. Thank you.
Evening, everyone. Over the course of a few days, in early March, we started up a new committee with staff members, the Hillcrest Student Recognition Committee. So their first event was held a few weeks ago for all first semester honor roll students, and each student was invited. We closed out the IMC, and each student was in the achieved honor roll, came into the IMC. We fed them lunch. They played a bunch of different games with staff members. It was a great event. Girls basketball won a regional championship 55-51 over Kankakee, and boys basketball also won a regional championship this past season. DECA, we had two athletes placed in the top 5 of their competitive events at the state competition. This was this past weekend. Elizabeth King and Rain Phillips. We started up a different new club this year called the Hawks Adventure Club as well. They went on their first excursion last week, a field trip to, it's called Climb On in Homewood, rock climbing. Had a great time. Kara Triesenberg actually is very into outdoors and things like that, and she's one of our social workers. Very great connection. She makes really good connections with a lot of the students, so it just came about that some students said, yeah, this would be great, and they've got a few different events planned throughout the rest of this semester. And then, the third week of February, we had six young men volunteer to wake up about 4:30 in the morning, and with a few of our staff members, they headed over to UIC. There was an event that was called What's Next After High School for Black and Brown Males. They talked about finance, careers, college options, and things like that. It was a really good experience for those six young men. Thanks.
Thank you.
Hi, everyone. Bremen High School also had 9 students qualify last weekend to compete in nationals for DECA, so we're very proud of those students. In terms of academics, as we approach spring break here, we're getting ready for the SAT with our juniors. So we currently have 96 juniors that are working on SAT prep after school. That's twice a week. They're also, they've taken a full-length pre-test, and they're getting ready to take their full-length post-test next week before they get a little bit of a break before spring break. So they're gearing up for that April 13th exam. Sleep in Heavenly Peace, I think I mentioned this previously. We hosted a bunk bed build for the local organization. The local chapter here is in Oak Forest, Illinois. So we hosted that build at the end of February. Our Interact Club, Code of the Braves, and SCCLA did a collaboration on that. It's kind of a school-wide service project. And it cost $250 to build one bunk bed, and we actually raised $6,200. So we financed 24 beds, and that's the bed, the mattress, the comforter, pillowcases, all of those types of things. So we financed 24 beds. The kids built 12 beds that day that we hosted. And then we also had Ms. Connolly and a few students go on a delivery where they went with the group Sleep in Heavenly Peace, delivered the bed, and it was kind of cool because it went to a Bremen alum and their family that lives locally. So it did, not only did we do something great at Bremen, but it shared awareness for families in our community that this exists if they need assistance in that way. So we're really proud of the work that they did there. This week at Bremen is also Goose Chase Week. So in place of our Winter Fest, our student council planned a goose chase. So that is a scavenger hunt that's done online. I encourage you to Google it, look it up. There's an app the kids log on to. And basically there's tons of different challenges that our teachers, activity sponsors kind of gave suggestions for. So some of them, today was Hawaiian theme day. So it was find the teacher or staff member that's giving out lays and take a selfie with them. There's find a picture of the funniest street name in your town, take a selfie, submit it. Do a random act of kindness. So it's encouraging lots of different things, getting to know staff members, their peers. They earn points for prizes, so they get to go through March 20th to earn points for their challenges, and it's really kind of reinvigorated school spirit. So it's been a fun week to be a Brave.
Okay, thank you. Before Teresa goes, I'm sorry, I'm gonna blame it on not bringing my glasses tonight, but I wanna mention, sorry, that Katie Gomez at the competition, at the DECA competition, she was awarded the state DECA Educator of the Year. So just wanted to give her a shout out for that. I apologize.
No, thank you.
Good evening, everyone. Over at Delta Academy, since we last saw you, we have had 16 new students who have graduated since January, bringing our total so far the school year to 40 students. I'd like to just publicly recognize their names as after tonight's board meeting, the rest of the students who are finishing are all planning on walking in the homeschool ceremonies in May. So from Hillcrest, we had Taryn Ann Tribble, Anaya Whitehead, Darianne Barr, Mariana Norwood, Rennie Thurman, Janelle Sullivan. From Oak Forest, we had Rodolfo Monterosas. From Bremen, we had Alonzo Salas and Aaron Renteria, Kyle Joyce, Danny Hernandez, and Davian Diller. And from Tinley Park High School, we had Grace Snoddy, Trinity Walker, Ethan Roswalka, and Sarai Brannan. So those are our latest graduates, one of which just finished March 2nd, Danny Hernandez from Bremen, and he actually has his orientation tomorrow morning. He has signed up with South Suburban's Highway Construction Program, so he has orientation at 9 o'clock, and already has strict instructions that he's going to be returning to us immediately afterwards, so let's know how it goes, and that will start April 4th. But the goal with him is to have him not only attend this program, it's a 12-week course, but he's also going to come back then and speak to his classmates about how it's going. And hopefully get some more students to join him because it's a really great opportunity. In addition, we have currently 33 students in our I promised Dr. Sikora that I would roll in our good news report along with a school presentation tonight. And before I introduce you to these two fabulous individuals, I do hope you guys keep in mind, maybe you read about it in the patch a few times. We had a 2018 graduate, her name was Diana Ibarra, in a very serious car accident when she was driving back to U of I. She is actually not, she's in her second semester senior year. She's not going to be able to finish. Very serious extensive injuries. We've been trying to get in touch with the family. Unfortunately, the contacts that we had back in 2018 are no longer those same contacts. But we are, they have a GoFundMe page going, and we are going to do a little basketball and bun cakes. You know how I love my bun cakes, for those of you. So we'll do a bun cake sale, and then we're gonna have a student faculty basketball game on during 8th hour, the last day before we go home for spring break, just to bring a little bit of school spirit, raise a little bit of money, and try to help out Diana and her family through this terrible, terrible situation. So if you do read about it or hear about it, again, 2018 grad from Tinley, just lovely young lady. Tonight, our good news report is to share with you guys about our newly created, for the 2021-22 school year, our after-school study center. Something that was very sorely needed when kids need help after school. This, in addition to paper.co, I'm a big fan of paper.co and that tutoring opportunity for our students, but this gives live instruction from our teachers to our students, a safe place to stay, work on homework, and get some help 3 days a week after school in our library. The two ladies that head this up, we have Shannon Gormley, who oversees the program in totality, and then we have Lori Vitt, who is kind of an assistant to Shannon, but her focus is to draw our special education students to come after school to take advantage of these services. Sometimes our special education population is a little bit harder to tap into if they don't necessarily get that personal invitation, if they're not actually coached, see a familiar face of, like Lori Vitt, to say, hey, I'm gonna be there, come on down and work with these teachers. So it has been a remarkable success. I think it's a very a great use of our ESSER funds to close educational gaps from COVID, to provide a service to our kids. And they're gonna share with you about the program. They do have a little slideshow, so I know my people over here sometimes want to come over this way. So Shannon Gormley, Lori Vitt.
Shannon will go into a little more detail why the numbers are so different, but we were only open 24 days during semester one. We had 142 students, yet we had 568 visits. So 60% of the kids that were coming repeatedly more than twice. And the most visits by student that semester was 18, so they were there almost every single day. Mm-hmm. And then for semester two, we've been open 17 days. This data is up to date as of today when we had study center. 95 different students have come in so far. We've had 316 visits, so only about 56% repeat at this point. I want to point out also, it's hard to see. Semester one, about 27% of our students had an IEP, 504
then they will go and finish out practice with them. So we're working together.
A couple extra fun facts. Our freshmen are far beyond the most attended class that comes, which is great for freshmen on track. We have kids that are so dedicated to the study center. During seventh hour, the day that snow day was announced for the next day, we still had 14 kids show up for study center that day. That's how much they love it.
And we did have the opportunity to have some of our frequent visitors just give you a little bit of a taste of why they come to the study center. So the first one is Mari. She's a sophomore here at Sydney Park High School.
Hey, Mari. Tell us what you like about the study center.
Okay, Sydney's going to help me a lot. She tried to she helped me do my tests and focus and practice on my tests. Yeah, she helped me a lot. I've got a B on my test, actually.
All right!
She still helped me.
And how often do you come to the study center?
I come every day.
Every day, you do. And we love seeing you. You're one of our favorites.
Thank you.
Well, that's our itchy is what our favorite. The next student is Kylie. Kylie is a junior, and she graciously agreed to do a video, but only on her time. So because when I asked her, she had her
she's
like, can I send it to you on Monday?
Absolutely.
So this is Kylie.
This question I got asked is, how often do you attend the study center? Personally for me, I attend whenever I can. The second question I got asked is, how has the study center helped slash benefited you? Well, even as an AP and honors student, I feel as though a study center has helped me get extra support that I need and to feel more confident in the work that I've done.
And finally, we have Evan. Evan is also a sophomore here at Finley, and he also visits frequently. Semester one, he was a little bit hesitant, but I think we've gotten him to come around. He's a man of few words.
Yeah.
He is saying it helped his grades. Today we had a little QR code because we're very high tech of a survey for the students to take that had three simple questions. The first was, why do you come to the study center? And with anything with kids, you get all kinds of answers from anything like, my parents made me. I have to read this verbatim because Mr. Isaac was mentioned by one of our students. She's one of our math tutors and a favorite.
Yeah.
The study center provides a place where I can study in a quiet but engaging environment. When it comes to math, there's no one better than Ms. Strizek. She's calm, patient, and truly helps you understand how to do math very efficiently.
Wow.
I promise we did not coach them on whatsoever. The second question we asked is why you like study center. Because I think it's always important. I think I have an idea of why our students like it, but clearly you can see it gives them a place to work without distractions. They do have teachers there to help. It's more time to get their work done and tutor. It's quiet. And again, because they get that additional time. In addition to the 25 minutes they get in study hall, they also have an hour that they know that they can work. And I will tell you, the other thing is that it helps me study for the SAT. We are also running Khan Club, which is our targeted SAT practice through College Board and Khan Academy. And so we do have students who will come and kind of have them in a little, like a separate area where they'll work on getting that targeted practice with both math and English. And if they have specific math questions or specific English questions, Jackie Strizek will make sure that she's in there to kind of work through the problem with them. Tammy Schultz also will go in, who's our English tutor, and help them as well.
And then our last question, our last slide for you today, how can we improve the study center? Food. We started out giving snacks, but that got a little out of control, so we scaled back a bit, but if you want to talk about that.
Yeah, so I am of the opinion that kids need some kind of a snack after a long day. I'm a parent, you know. So we started with the snacks. We're also teaching life skills. So we're teaching them that you can't just take two or three handfuls of snacks and squirrel it away for later. Let's make sure that we're making everybody in the study center gets a snack or two, but we will be getting the snacks back for them. That's it, unless you guys have any questions for us.
Thank you.
And you know what, we will be presenting that at our data retreat as well, because actually what they hit on was the fact that, you know, improving our graduation rate and our freshman on track were two of our main goals as a smart administration. And as you can see, the freshmen are the ones that are coming, and so they're the ones that are getting the help. So obviously a direct reflection that will help us attain our goal. Thank you, ladies.
Since the last regular board meeting, we've received the following Freedom of Information Act requests. Diana Loesch, on behalf of the parents of D228, requested copies of public official surety bond required by Illinois 15 ILCS 405/3 from Chapter 15, Paragraph 203. The Governing Board of Education blanket surety bond, errors and omissions, a surety liability insurance policy, the duty of care policy, of his school board general obligations bond, general long-term bond for the school board crime policy, risk management policy, ACORD 125, ACORD 126, ACORD 127, ACORD 128, certificate of liability, public officials and or any other bonds pertaining to proof of liability and policies, faithful performance bond, fidelity bond, public employee dishonesty policy, public employee blanket bond, statutory bond, official bond, power of attorney for the surety bond company, blanket bond, power of attorney for the surety bond company, oath of office. This request has been completed. Melissa D'Amico, parent, requested detailed information on the $15 million that D228 received. This request has been completed. Diane Loesch, on behalf of the parents of D228, requested copies of performance goals as required by the Illinois School Code and plans to formulate goals that pertains to Brad Sikora, superintendent, the most recent school district 228 budget and or tentative budget, funds that School District 228 received in the most recent fiscal year under Federal Emergency Aid for Public Education, allocations to LEAs under ESSER and GEAR, public official surety bond pertaining to Brad Sikora, superintendent, public official surety bond required by Illinois 15 ILCS 405/3 from Chapter 15, Paragraph 203. The Governing Board of Education blanket surety bond, errors and omissions, a surety liability insurance policy and the duty of care policy of the school board general obligation bond. General long-term bond for the school board crime policy, risk management policy, ACORD 125, 126, 127, and 128. Certificate of liability, public officials and or any other bonds pertaining to proof of liability and policies, faithful performance bond, fidelity bond, public employee dishonesty policy, public employee blanket bond, statutory bond, official bond, power of attorney for the surety bond company, blanket bond, power of attorney for the surety bond company, oath of office. This request has been completed. Preston Deedy, Chicagolandconstruction.com, requested bid results, tabulations, or award for 2/10/2022 Bremen High School parking lot improvements and classroom remodelings at Oak Forest High School, Hillcrest High School parking lot improvements, Oak Forest High School IMC roof replacement. This request has been completed. Thomas Haley, construction analyst, requested the bid tabulation and engineer's estimate, if the project has been awarded, to whom it has been awarded, the start date, estimated end date, and a list of subcontractors, if applicable, for the Bremen High School parking lot improvement project. This request has been completed. Nathan Mahilik, Illinois Retired Teachers Association, requested the names and email address of any certified staff who are retiring this year. This request has been completed. And finally, Ted Novak requested copies of public official surety bond required by Illinois 15 ILCS 405/3 from Chapter 15, Paragraph 203. The Governing Board of Education blanket surety bond, errors and omissions, surety liability insurance policy, and the duty of care policy of his general school board general obligations bond, general long-term bond for the school board crime policy, risk management policy, ACORD 125, 126, 127, 128, certificate of liability, public officials and or other bonds pertaining to proof of liability and policies, faithful performance bond, fidelity bond, public employee dishonesty policy, public employee blanket bond, statutory bond, official bond, power of attorney for the surety bond company, blanket bond, power of attorney for the surety bond company, oath of office for Bill Kendall, Dr. Corinne Williams, Dr. Dan Goggins, Ms. Jamie Bonema, Dr. Jim Boswell, Mr. Kevin Baffo, Mrs. Brittany Morrison, Dr. Lisa Giulio Bisek, Mr. Jeff Staley, Board of Education, or any other elected leadership personnel. This request has been completed, and thank you for bearing with me.
Sounds like a busy month for
yes.
Any other board member reports? Any board members?
I was able to take the day off work on February 28th and go around the schools, see how everyone's been recovering this year to having a more normal year instead of online learning. Thank you, Dr. Secor, for going around with me. Thank you to the personnel of each of the buildings that showed me around, made me feel welcome. Doing a lot of good things. Hopefully next year is even more back to normal. We can keep everything going strong. Thank you.
Any other board members?
Yes, I shared a walkthrough with the buildings on February 23rd. And I'm amazed at what the kids are doing. Oak Forest, auto shop, and they also have like a wood shop. So they did a mock build-up of a building and then constructed it in full size, from what I understand. I was kind of disappointed that maybe they could have built that press box over at Grant. You know, we give them an opportunity to do that, and it saves the district $100,000. Well, that's minus the materials and stuff. But we paid $100,000 for that. Tinley, for the first time I went through the new construction over there and saw the scape and the commitment to the athletes with having a weight training program. And then they also had music where they're putting out ideas for kids to pursue that normally high risk type of thing out there as far as schools. 5 years ago, as you may remember, I tried to have a bunch of kids come out and sing a concert here at Vernon, and then it would have turned into a round table where these kids could ask questions of these people who are actually in the field of singing and all the ups and downs and stuff that they could experience. We had a great singer that came out there, Miss Day song that, you know, I'll Rise, and she sung that better than I thought.
The artist.
she really blew it, but you know, those are things I'm glad that we are exposing our kids to. Bremen had a camera that's what is used in the fields and stuff like that, and that allows them to put on their own TV production. So, I mean, it was great. Hillcrest had a lot of good things in there that is coming along that day. I apologize to Mr. Tomlin for giving him a hard time. I want our athletes, who parents have taken the light bill money, gas bill money, or whatever, put their kids in these programs. And I want as much emphasis on that as we would for any of the other parts of it. I mean, if they want to escape poverty, they need to be able to have it. Opportunity open up to them. For Dr. Nolan to provide a weight training coach and stuff like that, we should receive reflective on that field out there. And I'll leave it at that.
Thank you very much, Mr. Johnson. Thank you for your report. Any other board member reports? Okay, moving on to new business, Ms. Morrison.
Item 6.1 is the bills, addendum to bills, payroll, and CBS bills. These items are being recommended for full board approval.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Ms. Canfor, second by Ms. Gleason. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Mrs. Canfor, aye. Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
Item 6.2 is the FY22 property tax relief grant resolution and abatement certification. This item is being recommended for full board approval.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Mr. Wickham, second by Ms. List. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. Canfor, aye. Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
Item 6.3 is the resolution directing allocation of expenses for IMRF and Social Security purposes. This item is being recommended for full board approval.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Ms. Gleason, second by Ms. List. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. Canfor, aye. Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
Item 6.4 is the bid rejection from Sullivan Electric per the letter submitted to the Board of Education for the domestic water piping project at Bremen. This item is being recommended for full board approval.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Mr. Wickham, second by Ms. List. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. Canfor, aye. Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
Item 6.5 is the bid acceptance report for the Bremen domestic water piping project. The vendors recommended are Midway Contracting Group, $192,850, Cosgrove Construction, $432,000, CJ Erickson, $557,000, and Sullivan Electric, $439,280. These items are being recommended for full board approval.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Ms. Gleason, second by Ms. Campworth. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mrs. Campworth, aye. Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
Item 6.6 is the bid acceptance report for the Bremen parking lot and tennis court. The vendors recommended are M&J Asphalt, $888,333, Jasco Electric, $120,188, Peerless Fence, $148,244, and Landworks Limited, $132,500. These items are being recommended for full board approval.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Mr. Wickham, second by Ms. List. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. Campbell, aye. Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
Item 6.7 is the bid acceptance report for the Hillcrest parking lot and tennis court. The vendors recommended are McGill Asphalt, $948,210.22, Jasco Electric, $171,888, Peerless Fence, $210,325, and Landworks Limited for $148,000. These items are being recommended for full board approval.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Mr. Wickham, second by Ms. List. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. Campbell, aye. Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
Item 6.8 is the bid acceptance report for the Oak Forest classroom and office space renovation. The vendors recommended are Moran Electric for $69,700, Reichelt Plumbing for $14,000, Amber Mechanical $57,300, Cosgrove Construction $254,700. These items are being recommended for full board approval.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Ms. Gleason, second by Mr. Wickham. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. Campworth? Aye. Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
Item 6.9 is the acceptance of the Oak Forest IMC roof renovation project with RB Crowther for $302,300. This item is being recommended for full board approval.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Ms. Gleason, second by Ms. Campworth. Any discussion? Roll call.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mrs. Campworth? Aye. Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. Camworth, aye. Mrs. Russell?
Aye. Item 6.11, Dr. Williams?
Thank you, Mrs. Russell. 6.11 is the overnight field trip request for Oak Forest BPA to attend the national convention. This is being recommended for full board approval.
So moved.
Moved by Ms. List, second by Ms. Gleason. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. Camworth, aye. Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. Russell?
Aye.
Item 6.12 are calendar changes for this school year and the next school year. As you read in the memo, I forgot to take into consideration AP testing, and the first SIP falls on an AP exam, so we have to move the SIP to the following week. We'll do the same thing for the next school calendar, because I did it again. Sorry about that. The superintendent has reviewed these changes and is recommending them for full board approval.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Mr. Wickham, second by Ms. Camworth. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. Camworth, aye. Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mrs. Russell?
Aye. Personnel recommendations, Dr. Goggins?
Under leaves, Jane Molek, Chrissy Opsel, and Andrew Rabarchik. Under retirement, Dan Chambers, James Hassel, Jean Burke, and Jennifer Greenway. Under resignation, Maureen Deering, Samantha Cravens, Anthony Wilkins, Amanda DeLucasis, and Courtney O'Shea. Under change in position, Tom O'Shea, Maurice Young, Matt Mansky, and Ryan Blackwell. And under employment, Melissa Tyson, Joseph Franklin, Brianna Gill, Beth Conlin, Shannon Deering, and Brittany Buchanan. Also under retirement is Kevin Donigan. These are recommended to the full board for approval.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Mr. Wickham, second by Ms. Gleason. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Wickham?
Aye.
Mrs. Gleason?
Aye.
Mr. Johnson? Mrs. Camworth, aye. Mrs. List?
Aye.
Mrs. Russell?
Aye. Can I get a motion to go to closed session to consider the appointment, employment, compensation, discipline, performance, or dismissal of specific employees? Five ILSC, collective bargaining matters, five ILC 120, and litigation, five ILC 120, subsection 2C11.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Mr. Wickham, second by Ms. List. Roll call, please.
Mr. Wickham?
Aye.